Okay, quickly, we'll go. I'm going to take a modifications of JAC today. Okay, so quickly we'll recap. So what exactly is taught before and all entirely about the JAC. Okay. So you heard of JAC, glass ionomer cement. Okay, it's a glass ionomer cement. So why it is named as glass ionomer? Because what happens, once upon a time, only there was a silver amalgam for the restoration. It may be anterior or it may be posterior. Every tooth, they used to fill it with the silver amalgam. But later in around 1970, 1960, people have started searching for the other cement. At that time, they have started searching for which, because silver amalgam, the problem was, so silver amalgam was black in color. So people were not happy with the color of a tooth, color of the restoration. So they wanted something which is tooth colored. Okay. Tooth colored in the sense, they were searching for a cement like zinc phosphate, zinc oxide, eugenol. There are so many cements they were searching. But nothing was as good as clear or as glass like tooth. You must have seen tooth has a color which has a shiny surface, so it is not like dull. So the restoration which you should be able to match with the tooth, it is not only with the color, white color, it has to match with the refractive index of the tooth. Okay, so that is how the search for a good restoration machine, good restorative cement was started. In that search, one cement which is very popular is known as glass ionomer cement. So name itself, it says that it has a glass. Glass means what? It's a glass is the one where you have a shiny surface or a mirror-like appearance. So tooth is also like it has a shiny surface. Also, it has tooth-like appearance. So there is another one, glass ionomer. Ionomer is what? It has ions in it. That is the reason it is called as ionomer. And cement, it is a powder liquid. That is why it is called as cement. Glass ionomer cement. So it is also called as polyalkanate cements, aluminum silicate polyacrylic acid. Okay, this is all the other names. So the synonyms. So I'm not going to detail about all these things. Okay, it's all taught, right? So I'll just go briefly about the. So this was introduced by the famous scientist called as Wilson and Kent in 1972. This GAC was introduced by them, Wilson and Kent. Remember this? There are so many classifications. The famous classification is type 1, type 2, type 3, and type 4. Okay, this is one of a very famous classification. What is type 1? Type 1 is luting cements. You know what is luting cements? Luting cements is nothing but to stick something. Like suppose you have a crown. Crown has to be crown in the sense cap. Tooth ko cap rehta na, tooth ke upar cap banate. Cap ko you have to stick the cap to the tooth surface. So you require some adhesive cement, which is adhesive in the sense you are using zinc phosphate cement. Zinc phosphate mein do consistency rehta. Ek zinc luting consistency aur ek base consistency. Okay, luting consistency is nothing but it is very thin. So you must have seen that. Up, usko starting mein jada liquid dala, to wo banta hai. Starting mein jo banta hai, thick. So as you go on adding little more powder, it becomes thin. It becomes thick, more thicker. Or viscosity becomes, it becomes more thick consistency. That is called as base consistency. So for any adhesive to stick something, it has to have a very very thin consistency. Or we can say film thickness is very less. That is a type 1 is a luting cement. Always, GAC has a type 1. And टाइप टू इज रेस्टोरेटिव, मीन्स वॉट, लूटिंग सीमेंट्स में जो थिन रहता है ना, इसलिए उसका स्ट्रेंथ ज्यादा नहीं रहता, वो जस्ट जस्ट फॉर अ स्टिकिंग सरफेस पर्पस. Whereas your restorative GAC, which has little more strength because it's more more thicker, which is used for a filling purpose. Okay, restorative. And a type 3 is lining or a base. So for a base purpose, it in between luting and a restorative. It is for a base purpose. That is lining or a base. Type 4 is a core buildup. This is very famous classifications. You should remember. Type 1, luting. Type 2, restorative. Type 3, lining. Type 4, core buildup. This is the 2 marks question, and it's also Viva question. So this is not necessary. I'm not going to. This can be available in the powder liquid. Okay. So classic composition, I'm not going to go in very detail. So you are aware of all these things. Okay. Should I explain all these things or directly go to a modification? Should I explain or directly? Anyone? Okay. Then the major is like, okay, so you wanted to know about the core buildup, right? Somebody has asked me. Okay. So core buildup is nothing but, so suppose abhi aap root canal karte ho. Okay. Root canal karne ke baad, रूट कैनल करने के बाद उसको फिलिंग करना पड़ता है. रूट कैनल करने के बाद क्या करते हैं, एनामल निकालते हैं, डेंटिन निकालने के बाद. सो व्हेन यू फिल द होल कैविटी, दैट इज द होल रूट कैनल पल्प चेंबर विद द फिलिंग, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज कोर बिल्डअप. ओके ओके, सो वी आर नॉट गोइंग वेरी डिटेल इन टू द लिक्विड पार्ट एंड एवरीथिंग. सो यू शुड ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दिस, इट हैज अ पॉलीएक्रिलिक एसिड मेजर, एंड पॉलीएक्रिलिक एसिड इज co-polymerized with itaconic, malic and tricarbolic. And there are other two is this, there are tartaric acid and a water, very very important composition. This composition will be asked starting from your UG second BDS to, if you are doing a PG also, till that time this will be asked. So it's a white white in color setting reaction. I'm not going to go deep detail. Okay, how it happens, it's all not necessary. Okay, mixing and everything you have studied. Okay, finishing. Now I'll properties also. The major property is, there are three properties are important. One is mechanical property, solubility and disintegration. This is one of a very important property, is adhesion. So silver amalgam is mechanically adhere to the tooth structure, whereas your GAC is chemically adhere to the tooth structure because of the nature of the liquid. Okay. GAC adheres chemically. Only one cement which is invented till today, none of the cement is chemically adherent to the tooth structure. Only GAC is chemically adherent to the tooth structure. If this is a Viva question, so people will ask you, so the in Viva they are going to ask, which is the tooth, which is the name one material which is chemically adhered to the tooth structure, that is only GAC. None of the material is chemically adhered to the tooth structure. This is one of a very big advantage of GAC. So what, how bonding occurs? Because of the carboxyl group of the polyacids, they have a polyacrylic acid. It is copolymerized with many itaconic, malic and tricarbolic acid. So, and tooth has a calcium. So there will be a bonding between the carboxyl group of the polyacid and a calcium. So because of that, there is a bonding. And GAC is considered to be aesthetic restorative material. Because unlike amalgam was black in color, GAC is white in color. It can be used as a, but nowadays we have a composite resin which is better aesthetic material. So GAC is not much of used as a aesthetic material, but still it is very popular in a class 5 cavities. it's a tooth color. It is white in color, but it lacks with the refractive index. And GIC is biocompatible. What is the major advantage of GIC? One is it is chemically bind to the tooth structure. Second one is it is a tooth color restoration. Third one is biocompatible, because the biocompatibility is because of the polyacrylic acid, which is more pulpal friendly than the phosphoric acid. If you ask me which is the best base material to be used below the amalgam, below any restoration, that is GIC, not the zinc phosphate. Zinc phosphate has a strength, GIC also strength, but GIC is more biocompatible than the zinc phosphate. Since zinc phosphate is cheaper, so we are using in the colleges in second BDS and everywhere, so that you are using, because you take loads of cements, so that college will become bankrupt if you started giving you a GIC for everybody. You will waste a lot. So for a learning purpose, we give zinc phosphate as a base, but for a base, the best base is GIC. And the fourth property, which is very important, is anti-kerogenic property. That is, GIC in a powder, it has got three types of fluorides. So fluorides are known as anti-kerogenic. So when you give suppose certain amount of the bacteria is present in the cavity, certain bacteria is present, this fluorides will act as an anti-kerogenic, so that bacteria will be dead. So that is another major advantage of. So what is the advantage? One is aesthetic. It is a tooth color restorative material. Second one is it is chemically binding to the tooth structure. Third one is it is very biocompatible. Fourth one is it is anti-kerogenic property. Okay. Anti-kerogenic properties. It can be used for a majorly used in a class 5, and sometimes you can use for a class 1, class 3, and a class 4 very rarely used. Now comes modifications of GIC. Okay, there are two modifications. One is metal modified, other one is resin modified. What all are metal modified and a resin modified? First one we'll know known for a. We'll learn about the metal modified, metal reinforced GIC or a metal modified GIC. What happened? So they are able to increase the strength. Okay, what happened? So GIC, one of the major drawbacks is that there is a less strength. Okay, so strength was very less. So what happens? So amalgam has very good strength. Okay, so amalgam has very, very good strength. So when you are so GIC was strength wise, when you take up the compressive strength or tensile strength, GIC has a less strength, and there is a GIC is having a fracture toughness also is lesser than the amalgam. So and it can, what happens after longer time use, suppose class 1 or a class 2, what happens, there is the wear, the upper tooth and lower tooth in come into contact, they occlude each other, so that is the reason wear occurs. So that is wear also. Then adhesive property and anti-kerogenicity, because the amalgam was, it doesn't have adhesive property. Amalgam does not have anti-kerogenicity, but amalgam has strength, amalgam has fracture resistance, amalgam has resistance to wear. So inko silver, I mean GIC mein ye hai, amalgam mein ye hai. Okay, combine kiya to kya hoga, hai na? Metal add kiya, koi bhi GIC mein thoda sa metal surface add kiya, metal. You all know that metal is very good, has a very good strength. Okay, metal se strength badhta hai. So GIC mein already property hai, anti-kerogenicity hai, adhesive property hai. So that when you start mixing together, so that will be the best thing to do. So people had started thinking that. So adding metal into the GIC, that is called as metal modified GIC or a metal reinforced GIC. This is one of the modification is done to improve the GIC properties. What properties? Strength, fracture resistance, and a resistance wear. By retaining adhesive property, anti-kerogenicity, to some extent aesthetic property, to some extent biocompatibility. So isme metal modified GIC mein do types hai. One is silver alloy admixed. Second one is cerment, that is Kitak silver. Two types of metal modified GIC. Remember this. how many types of metal modified GAC? There are two types. One is silver alloy admixed, or second one is SurMet. So what is silver alloy admixed? Usme kya karte? Carefully you listen to me here. What exactly happens? The silver alloy admixed, this is also called as miracle mix. Very, very popular term. This will be asked in Viva, and you may use it in your internship or in your private practice. Miracle mix. What is the miracle in this? Why it is called as miracle? Okay. In this, kya karte hum log? Silver GAC powder lete hai, aur GAC ka liquid lete hai. Okay. GAC powder and GAC liquid. So powder or liquid mix karte, how you mix it like a zinc phosphate mein. Okay. So problem kya hai? Powder mein metal nahi hai. So if you add a little powder, matlab silver alloy powder to the GAC powder. So mix karne ke baad kya hoga? Wo silver alloy GAC mein GAC powder ke saath silver alloy mix kiya. So powder ban gaya with the metal modified. Metal usko add ho gaya. So GAC ka liquid same hai. So when you mix both together, this is called as miracle mix. You get a metal modified GAC where silver alloy powder is added to GAC powder. Mechanically or sometimes manually, like how you are, you can clinic mein aap ek scoop wo le sakte hai, GAC powder, ek scoop alloy powder, silver alloy powder, mix karo. Aur mix karne ke baad aapko ek powder milega. Uske saath GAC ka liquid le lo. Like how you mix it with the zinc phosphate. Then usko mix kar dene ka. Okay, this is called as miracle mix. But iska kya problem hota hai? Since you have added with the silver ka color kya hai? Silver powder ka aapne mein dekha hai, silver filling ke time. Silver alloy powder is blackish in color. When you add black metal to the white cement, the color will change. It will become gray, or it maybe sometimes it becomes more blackish. Okay, so in generally, in a chemically also, in a manufacturer ke paas bhi aapko mix ho ke bhi milta hai miracle mix. Aap mix karne ka jarurat nahi hai. Aapko silver alloy aur a powder mix ho ke bhi milta hai. Otherwise equal amount ka lene ka. SurMet means what? SurMet is like precious metals like silver, gold, titanium, palladium, etc. are incorporated in the glass powder. Isme kya kiya apne silver miracle mix mein? Aapne ek scoop ye liya, ek scoop wo liya. Baad mein aapne manually mix kiya. In a SurMet mein kya hota hai? It is manufacturer itself. They make a while manufacturing a GAC powder, they'll add the this silver, gold, titanium, palladium, jo metal ka jo powder add karte, saath mein wo manufacturing hota hai. Matlab uska manufacturing becomes in total. So powder mein hi wo already add ho ke hi milta hai. That is called as SurMet. Okay. So many metals they use, silver, palladium, but it is like a composition. Like aapko zinc phosphate powder mein, can you able to make out where exactly the each ingredient? So because wo already manufactured mix karke diya hai aapko. SurMet mein aise hi rehta hai, aapko powder milega. Powder mein aap logon ko pata bhi nahi chalega kidhar silver hai, kidhar zinc, because all this like a composition mein wo log manufacturer mix karte aur dete. This is the difference between the miracle mix or a silver alloy admix and a SurMet. So there are two types of metal modified GAC. One is miracle mix, other one is SurMet. Okay, SurMet is the one where manufacturer added silver, gold, titanium, palladium, etc. into the glass powder so that you get a powder and a liquid. But here silver alloy, the mixture of silver alloy, maybe it has silver, tin, copper, zinc. So silver alloy mein wo rehta hai na, silver, copper, tin, zinc admixed jo alloy rehta hai usme silver ka high copper alloy rahega, maybe because high copper is the better. So whole copper is added, the powder is added. So that is the major difference between the miracle mix and a SurMet. So this is about the metal modified. Okay, SurMet mein it is a better resistance to abrasion than the regular glass eye number. Occlusive resistance is also very good, and flexure length also a good one. Okay. Disadvantages, as I told you, it is gray in color, because we are happy with the GAC because it is a tooth color. It is white in color. Since you are added metal, to the color becomes gray, so it's as good as amalgam. So aesthetic restoration kar hi nahi sakte aap log. You can do only class 1 or a class 2 sometimes, but not class 3, not class 4, not in a class 5 in an anterior region. So that is one. Anti-corrosion, because aapne powder ke saath you have played. सो यू आर प्लेड विद द पाउडर पार्टिकल. सो पाउडर में आपका फ्लोराइड रहता है, आपने पाउडर के फ्लोराइड के साथ आपने ये किया, सो यू एडेड सम अदर मटेरियल, सो दैट व्हाट हैपेंस, द इननेट प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द फ्लोराइड विल बिकम रिड्यूस्ड, सो एंटी कैरोजेनिसिटी विल बी रिड्यूस्ड and exhibits frequent fracture when used for a class 2 because wo jo apne original property class amalgam jaisa utna fracture resistance nahi rehta because aapko GIC kiya, aap original amalgam bhi nahi, original GIC bhi nahi, wo in between ban jata. Hardness because it fast set itna fast hota hai na, aapko carving karne ka time hi nahi milta, aap you just have to fill it, you don't get it because it sets like a quickly within 1 or 2 minutes it sets, so you should be so quick to make it as a like tooth color, tooth shape dene ke liye bahut mushkil ho jata. Okay, so it can be used for a core builder, matlab aapko carving ka zarurat nahi, matlab maine bola bulb chamber mein bharna hai, sirf aapko bharna hai uske upar crown aane wala hai, so core builder ke liye use kar sakte hain. Class 1 cavity, aapko suppose tooth attrition hai, attrition matlab cusp pura wear up ho gaya, so udhar carve karne ki zarurat hi nahi hai, so you can use it sometime as a liner and pit and fissure sealants. पिटर फ्यूजन सीलेंट्स मतलब क्या होता है, अभी सपोज केरी शुरू होने वाला है, ऐसा लग रहा है उधर से बड़ा बड़ा पिट्स और फ्यूजर्स डीप है, उधर से आगे जाके केरी शुरू होता है, उसको सील करना है, सो तब इन सच केसेस यू कैन यूज इट. ओके, प्राइमरी टीथ में यूज कर सकते हैं. एंड मिरेकल मिक्स, एज आई टोल्ड यू, एडिंग सिल्वर अलॉय पाउडर टू अ टाइप 2 ग्लास आइनोमर सीमेंट, टाइप 2 इज वॉट, रेस्टोरेटिव ग्लास आइनोमर सीमेंट. ओके, एंड so mixing this powder admixed with the polyacrylic acid liquid was intended to make this first metal reinforced cement. Advantages sir, advantage kya hai, it compressive strength improve hota hai, tensile strength improve hota hai, creep resistance improve hota hai, this miracle mix also showed less micro leakage than the other glass enamel cement, increased dynamic flexural strength, high resistance to bending was observed. Disadvantages, so again it's the same disadvantage, grain color, एंटी क्रिजेंसिटी कम हो जाता है, फ्रीक्वेंट फ्रैक्चर होता है, इट हार्डन्स वेरी फास्ट, सो दिस इज अ. एंड अ सेकेंड एंटिटी इज कॉल्ड एज रेजिन मॉडिफाइड. सो मॉडिफाइड जीएसी में दो टाइप है, वन इज मेटल मॉडिफाइड, अदर वन इज रेजिन मॉडिफाइड. मेटल मॉडिफाइड में दो टाइप है अगेन, इट इज सब डिवाइडेड इंटू टू टाइप्स, वन इज मिरेकल मिक्स और अ सिल्वर अलॉय एडमिक्स, अदर वन इज सरमेट. मिरेकल मिक्स में सिल्वर अलॉय को एड करते पाउडर में, वेरे सरमेट में जो मैन्युफैक्चर इटसेल्फ दे ऐड सिल्वर पार्टिकल्स एंड पैलेडियम प्लैटिनम वगैरह, सो व्हाइल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग द पाउडर इटसेल्फ दे डू. ओके, देन कम्स रेजिन मॉडिफाइड. रेजिन मॉडिफाइड में भी दो टाइप है, सो लाइक हाउ मेटल मॉडिफाइड में दो टाइप है, सो एक है, वन इज योर मिरेकल मिक्स, अदर वन इज सरमेट. इन द रेजिन मॉडिफाइड देयर आर टू टाइप्स. ओके, वन इज बिकॉज व्हाई दिस रेजिन मॉडिफाइड, आई विल टेल यू. The resin-modified glass enamel restorative cements are a relatively recent development. They were introduced to overcome the problem associated with the conventional glass enamel at the same time preserving the clinical advantage of conventional materials. These combined technologies of resin composites and the conventional glass enamel. Abhi GIC is in between amalgam, in between composite. So GIC ko kya kiya? GIC ko amalgam ke saath combine kiya. तो मतलब मेटल के साथ किया तो वो बनता है मेटल मॉडिफाइड. जीआईसी को कॉम्पोजिट रेजिन के साथ ये मॉडिफाई किया उसको बनता है, वो बनता है रेजिन मॉडिफाइड. इतना इजी है. जीआईसी इज इन द सेंटर, इस बाजू में अमालगम है, उस बाजू में कॉम्पोजिट रेजिन है. अमालगम के साथ, अमालगम इज मेटल, इट बिकम्स मेटल मॉडिफाइड. जीआईसी को रेजिन से मॉडिफाई किया, इट बिकम्स रेजिन मॉडिफाइड. अमालगम में दो टाइप है, two divisions, and resin may be two types. It's as simple as that. Modifications of GAC is very very simple to understand. It's very very simple to write also. This combined the technology of resin composite and conventional glass ionomer. So क्योंकि क्या होता था अमाल, so सरमेट metal modified में GAC का property थोड़ा बहुत आ गया उधर, but जो color हुआ ही नहीं, color became black. So इसमें क्या होगा, GAC properties को resin modified में क्या होता है, sorry, composite resin may all good, which is very good in aesthetics property, very good in refractive index, all other things, but composite resin does not have a anti-kerogenicity. Composite resin does not have a chemically bonding to the tooth structure. Okay, all these things properties are not with the composite resin. So when you add the composite resin, so GAC to the composite resin, or a composite resin to the GAC, both the way, so the both properties will be incorporated, and they tried to get a one more type. Okay, so So there are two classifications. One is the dual cure. This is, I'm not going to tell all these things. This is not necessary. So there are two types. One is resin modified glass NMR. This you have to remember. उसमें हमने miracle mix और सरमेट याद किया. इसमें आपको ये याद करना है. Resin modified glass NMR. Second one is poly acid modified glass NMR composites. One is resin modified glass NMR. That is called RMGIC. Resin modified glass NMR cement. RMGIC. Other one is PMC. Not Pune Municipal Corporation. It is poly acid modified composites. याद रखो. PMC. Poly acid modified composite. This is also famous. They called as compomer because composite plus GAC glass ionomer. Composite ionomer. They became compomer. Okay, like that. So it is the name is mixed both together. आजकल करते ना तो दो name होगा तो एक कर देते. All you must have seen hashtag बन जाता है. So same way. This is the hashtag. So compomer is a hashtag. Composite plus ionomer. Poly acid modified composites, PMC. So first one we'll understand about the resin modified glass NMR. Composition is fluoroaminosilicate glass particles initiators for a light chemical curing. Okay, liquid mein water and polyacrylic acid or only polyacrylic acid or modified with GAC. Modified with methacrylate and hydroxymethacrylate, HEMA. इसमें क्या होता है रेजिन मॉडिफाइड जीएसी में इट्स अ जीएसी ओके इट इज जीएसी इट्स अ सीमेंट ओके ग्लास आयनोमर सीमेंट सो व्हाट इज जीएसी जीएसी इज इट्स अ जीएसी जीएसी में कैसे पाउडर और लिक्विड रहता है सो इसमें भी पाउडर और लिक्विड रहता है बट पाउडर में दे हैव एडेड एंड दे हैव एडेड फ्लोरो अमीनो सिलिकेट इनिशिएटर्स फॉर अ लाइट एंड लिक्विड में दे हैव एडेड विद अ methacrylate and hydroxymethacrylate. So because of the both the things they have a chemical cure as well as a light cure. Okay, like how they use it. So they have a improved translucency, better initial strength, its adhesion is better. इसमें क्या करते हैं पता है वो लोग आपके पास लिक्विड है पाउडर अपने जिंक फॉस्फेट पाउडर और लिक्विड कैसे रहता है जिंक फॉस्फेट पाउडर एक बॉटल में रहता है और लिक्विड और एक बॉटल में रहता है आप उसको एक स्कूप लेते हो ग्लास आयन जी इसमें डालते हैं आप लोग अपना ग्लास स्लैब में डालते हैं और एक ड्रॉप ऑफ लिक्विड डालते हैं वो मिक्स करते हैं मिक्स करके टूथ में अप्लाई करते हैं सो यू वेट फॉर सम टाइम इट सेट्स सो सेम वे हियर यू हैव अ पाउडर यू हैव अ लिक्विड ओके इन अ पाउडर इट इज नॉट लाइक नॉर्मल पाउडर जीएसी का जीएसी पाउडर में और लिक्विड में दोनों लिक्विड और पाउडर अलग अलग मिलता है पाउडर में उन्होंने थोड़ा बहुत फोटो एक्टिवेटर से ऐड किया है लिक्विड में रेजिन मॉडिफायर से ऐड किया लाइक हेमा एंड ऑल दे हैव एडेड सो व्हेन यू मिक्स इट दे हैव एसिड बेस रिएक्शन हाउ इट हैपेंस लाइक सेम एज योर नॉर्मल जीएसी सेटिंग रिएक्शन होता है उसके बाद अप्लाई किया अप्लाई करने के बाद क्या होता है आप सो हम जीएसी में या जिंक फॉस्फेट हम वेट करते थे सेटिंग होने के लिए इट यूज टू टेक अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम मे बी समटाइम्स इट विल टेक 5 मिनट्स 6 मिनट्स और 7 मिनट्स बट समटाइम्स पेशेंट्स में इतना सलाइवेशन रहता है बच्चे को पीडो पेशेंट्स रहते हैं पीडियाट्रिक पेशेंट्स में कैसे बच्चे कोऑपरेट नहीं करते उतना सेट होने तक वो मूव कर देते हैं उससे वजह से क्या होगा सीमेंट सेट नहीं होगा सो व्हेन यू पुट इट टू द कैविटी कैविटी में डाला आप कॉम्पोजिट का लाइट क्योर यूनिट है कॉम्पोजिट में ब्लू लाइट एक्टिवेट करते हैं वो सेट हो जाता है इसमें भी आप डाला कैविटी में सो अपने आप भी सेट हो जाएगा लाइक हाउ मेनी इट विल टेक अराउंड 10-15 मिनट्स टू सेट बट आपने लाइट डाला तो इमीडिएटली इट सेट्स लाइक अ कंपोजिट सो दैट इज द एडवांटेज सो सेटिंग टाइम इज अंडर योर कंट्रोल अनलाइक योर अदर जीएसी और एनी अदर सीमेंट सो दिस इज सिंस इट इज अ रेजिन मॉडिफाइड सो यू गेट अ सेटिंग टाइम अंडर योर कंट्रोल एंड सिंस इट इज अ रेजिन मॉडिफाइड यू हैव अ बेटर क्लिनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज लाइक इट हैज इन बिटवीन the GAC and a composite resin. And by retaining the anti-karyogenicity adhesions because it has a GAC particles itself. Okay, but kya hai? Because there is some polymerization shrinkage. There is compressive strength is slightly lower than the, because same thing. Uske saath mix kiya to utna property nahi milega. Iska bhi milega, uska milega, in between aaja. The second entity is called as poly acid modified composites or a compomer. Okay, first one is resin modified GAC, second one is poly acid modified GAC. Okay, okay, here composition as compomer using a provided as a good posterior life cure material for a restorative application. Okay, it consists of a silicate glass particle, sodium fluoride, and a polyacid modified monomer without any water. Moisture sensitive, recently for a looting purpose provided. Isme kya hota hai? So isme usme kya kiya tha humne resin modified mein GAC ko hum powder liquid mein add kiya tha. Idhar GAC ko composite ke sath add kiya gaya. As simple as that. Udhar resin mein GAC ko resin add kiya, idhar resin ko GAC add kiya. Isliye polyacid modified composite. The name itself, polyacid modified composite. Either composite is modified by a polyacid. So that is why it's called as compomer. Composite mein ionomer hai. Composite mein GAC hai. Okay? So this is the compomer. It acts as a, it's, so aapne composite mein, aapne dekha rahega composite kaise rehta hai karke. Nahi dekha? To kal mein, I'll try to show you a case of how you use the composite. Tomorrow, I have one more class, right? For you. Composite resin revision class. So that time I'll try to explain you about the composite manipulation, how we do, how composite looks, how composite can be adapted to the tool structure. Okay, so that time you must have seen composite mein ek paste rehta hai, one paste, like paste or a like little thicker in consistency. So wo jo composite hai, so that can be placed like anything, you can mold like anything. So usme unhone place after phosphoric acid etching ke baad बॉन्डिंग एजेंट लगाते हैं, सेम थिंग कॉम्पोजिट जैसे ही करते हैं, बट ये जो कॉम्पोजिट में जीएसी का मॉडिफिकेशंस किया है. ओके, बट द इवन जीएसी मॉडिफिकेशंस किया तो भी फ्लोराइड रिलीज उतना ज्यादा नहीं है, लाइक कन्वेंशनल जीएसी जैसा नहीं है. बॉन्ड स्ट्रेंथ इज इक्वल टू जीएसी, मेन यूज इन अ क्लास 3 एंड अ क्लास 5. कैन यू सी दिस? दिस इज द वन सेकंड पिक्चर. माई कैन यू सी माई एरो? द सेकंड पिक्चर, दिस एरो, यू कैन यू जस्ट फॉलो द एरो. दिस इज light cure. Can you see this? GC is a company. So this is a light cure. This is powder and liquid. This is resin modified GAC. Whereas this one is a this is both are resin modified GAC. And that's it. That other one is polyacid. So can you heard of sandwich technique? Okay, bilayered sandwich technique. So in that, in a sandwich technique, so GAC ko base dete. Can you see this? Suppose कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड का लाइनर देते हैं, मतलब इट्स फॉर अ रिफ्रिजरेंट इनटू फॉर्म. कैन यू सी अ जीएसी हियर? दिस वन, फॉलो द एरो. ओके, कैन यू सी अ जीएसी हियर? जीएसी बेस ऑन दैट कॉम्पोजिट. सो व्हेन द कॉम्पोजिट जीएसी इज इन बिटवीन द टूथ एंड अ कॉम्पोजिट, दे आर सैंडविच्ड. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज सैंडविच टेक्निक. सो सिंस यू हैव यूज्ड द जीएसी इन बिटवीन, सो जीएसी हैज अ एंटी कैरियोजेनिसिटी, जीएसी हैज अ फ्लोराइड रिलीज, GAC has chemical binding to the tooth structure. Because of all these things, so this the tooth gets a good property because of the GAC. Okay, whereas composite, on top of it you are applying a composite, so what happens, so because of the composite, so all wear resistance or fracture resistance all will be, because tooth is going to get occluded by a composite. So this example, I can see the arrow, third picture, lower wala, can you see composite? Composite is on top, GAC at the base, or sometimes at the, because that base will use only axial wall pulpal floor. Most of the time, base is placed in the, sometimes we place it in the gingival floor also, gingival seat also. This is called as open sandwich. Open sandwich. Sandwich is open to the external surface. If the GAC is placed only at the axial wall and a pulpal floor, that is called as closed sandwich, because the composite is entirely covering the GAC, or GAC is closed within the composite. Okay, that is called as closed sandwich. So it is, if GAC is placed in between the tooth and the composite, that is called as sandwich technique. So this is technique, combination glass ionomer and a composite. Okay, this is one of a good method to get a both the, to get both the properties. Cement mix karna hai. पहले सीमेंट ऐड करने का, लाइक दिस, आपने सीमेंट ऐड किया ऐसा, फर्स्ट जीएसी ऐड करो. जीएसी ऐड करने के बाद, इसके पहले आप एच वगैरह नहीं करने का, कुछ नहीं करना, जस्ट जीएसी ऐड करना, लाइक दिस. जीएसी ऐड करने के बाद जीएसी को यू हैव टू एच इट विद द फॉस्फोरिक एसिड, 37 फॉस्फोरिक एसिड एच करना है जीएसी को बॉन्ड करने का, एंड देन कॉम्पोजिट ऑन उसके ऊपर प्लेस करना है. okay, mixing and placement of the cement, acid etching, application of resin bonding and bonding cement, placement of the whirling composite resin. So advantage kya hai? It's an ionic addition of a glass enamel cement to the dentin. Less composite resin to be placed. Composite resin ज़्यादा place करने की ज़रूरत ही नहीं है, because बीच में आया GAC. उसके ऊपर आपको composite resin place करना है. Minimize the number of increments of composite because you have half of the things is covered by GAC. And one can achieve anti-kerogenicity and better bonding capacity of GAC with better strength and aesthetic composites. Recent advances में because आपने type 1, type 2, type 3, type 4 वगैरह सुना है आपने. Type 1 is looting, type 2 is restorative, type 3 is liners and bases, type 4 is core buildup. अभी आजकल type 9 तक आया है, मतलब type 5, type 6, type 7, type 8, type 9 तक. There are so many types are available. But it is commercially done by Fuji करके company है, because all the GAC or composite resins are majorly the most research is done by the by Japanese have done a lots of research on GAC. Okay, so there Fuji is a most of the it's a very famous company, GC karke hai. This is from Japan company. They have made a modifications up to 9. The type 9 is a posterior composite, posterior GAC. You get a pink color GAC, you get a black. Okay, can you see this? The first picture, pink color. Where you can use the pink color GAC? For kids. Kids gets attracted to a colored GAC, pink color. तो उनको कैविटी फिल किया तो उनको अच्छा लगे, अरे पिंक कलर बन गया. ब्लू कलर का भी अवेलेबल रहता है. ओके, कैप्सूल में भी रहता है टाइप 7 में. ओके, देयर सो मेनी टाइप्स. सो कंक्लूजन अबाउट द जीएसी इज जीएसी राइट्स टू अ पोएम, जीएसी राइट्स टू अ डेंटिस्ट. एस्थेटिक इज व्हाट आई एम, जेंटल फ्रेंडली इन एनी सिचुएशन दोस टू आई एम, हैंडल मी विद केयर एज आई कैन बी द नेक्स्ट बेस्ट थिंग टू व्हाट अ टूथ कैन एवर हैव. Pamper me, protect me in my childhood years. I shall be grateful and benefit you till death do us apart. GAC is one of a very, very good material. GAC should be used because that is still, even though there are better materials are available, like for a aesthetic purpose, composite resin is there, but GAC is irreplaceable. Every clinic uses GAC like in anything. Any clinical practice, if you don't have a GAC, you cannot run a clinical practice. GAC is very useful in class 5 use. GAC is very useful in bases. GAC is very useful in small cavities. GAC very, very, very useful when there is a lots of caries activity in the mouth. So many things. But GAC has its own problems. Like initially, solubility is very, very high. So you have to protect the GAC. Aap logon ne varnish suna hai, varnish. There is cavity varnish, base, and liners. ओके, सो कैविटी वार्निश क्या करते हैं, अमालगम का पहले आप अप्लाई करते हैं, है ना. अमालगम क्या कैविटी बनाते हैं, कैविटी बनाने के बाद पूरा वॉल्स के ऊपर वार्निश लगाते हैं, उसके बाद अमालगम रेस्टोरेशन करते हैं. क्यों वार्निश अप्लाई करते हैं, बिकॉज अमालगम इनिशियली सील नहीं करता. देर इज अ गैप बिटवीन द अमालगम एंड अ कैविटी वॉल. अमालगम रेस्टोरेशन एंड अ कैविटी वॉल, उसमें इनिशियली वो गैप रहता है, उसके बीच में बैक्टीरिया अंदर जा सकते हैं, बिकॉज बैक्टीरिया इज अ वेरी माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज माइक्रो लीकेज. So when you apply a varnish on the walls, it will prevent the leakage, because the varnish is present in between the wall and a amalgam. So after some time, varnish will get dissolved, but see that amalgam will get corrosion products. So amalgam becomes self-sealing restoration. Okay, but in GAC, varnish pehle apply nahi karna, kyunki varnish apply kare to GAC tooth ko chipkega hi nahi, because adhesive property rahega hi nahi. So varnish also, GAC में भी varnish apply करते, where on the surface of the GAC. क्यों apply करते on the surface of the GAC? So that initial period में पानी आ गया, water आ गया, तो still it sets, GAC soluble हो सकता है, और GAC का ऊपर का layer चला जाएगा. इसलिए आपने varnish लगाया, तो GAC will be protected. Varnish नहीं रहेगा, तो हम लोग Vaseline लगाते, Vaseline. Okay, so that वो क्या होता है, GAC के ऊपर एक layer रह जाता है, so that water solubility will be less. So this is another thing. So you have to protect the GAC in the initial period, because after some time GAC gets a proper setting time होने के बाद GAC becomes proper, and GAC cannot be used in a high occlusal resistance, occlusal stress area. GAC has to be used very carefully. So thank you. So I will take any questions. So you can one by one you can ask instead of writing in a like thing. So if anybody has a questions, they can you can ask, you can unmute and ask. Any questions? कुछ समझ में आया, कुछ समझ में नहीं आया, कुछ और भी बोलना है और एक 10 minutes time है. कुछ explain करना है, कुछ जैसे ये revision class है, it is not going to be repeated again. आपको exams तक आएगा. Exams में भी यही question, JAC is like a main question. Most of the time there are तीन questions main आता है. One amalgam, other one is JAC, other one is composite essay. इसमें one essay is guaranteed. So GAC आपको properly मानो होना चाहिए. GAC not only in second year, final year में भी आपको essay आएगा, essay question आ सकता है. और you don't believe in GAC के ऊपर एक textbook है. Follow me आपको. There is a textbook on GAC. आप लाइब्रेरी में देखो, लाइब्रेरी में एक textbook है. इतना GAC के ऊपर रिसर्च हो चुका है, GAC के ऊपर लिख सकते हैं. In MDS, GAC comes as a 100 mark question. Only one question. That's it. Glass, ionomer, cement, 100 marks. So that is the importance of GAC. So you can't ignore GAC entire in your life. So कोई भी आपको इसके बाद सिखाएंगे नहीं. Maybe you are doing PG in conservative dentistry. No one is going to teach you about the GAC. किसी को कुछ पूछना है? समझ में नहीं आया GAC के बारे में?
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Good morning. बोलो.
Sir, can you please repeat what you explained about varnishes?
Varnishes, okay. So varnish kya hota hai? See, the definition of varnish is it's a resin or a copal resin dissolved in a organic solvents like acetone, ketone or ether. Okay, what happens? So ye jo liquid hai, matlab in the sense like one liquid. Liquid when you because wo jo resin particles hai na, resin particles are dissolved. The resin particles are dissolved in a organic solvent. जो वार्निश के ऊपर अंदर resin particle powder है, powder is dissolved in the organic like alcohol. So क्या powder को आपको tooth के ऊपर walls के ऊपर apply कर सकते क्या? रुकेगा नहीं. आपको powder को apply करने के लिए आपको कुछ ना कुछ vehicle लगेगा. Vehicle in the sense कम liquid लगेगा. So liquid आपने apply किया वार्निश के tooth के ऊपर apply किया. Tooth के ऊपर apply करने के बाद थोड़ी देर के बाद जो since it is a ethyl alcohol और alcohol based है एसीटोन वगैरह, सो वो इवापोरेट हो जाता है. इवापोरेट होने के बाद बचेगा कौन सा, क्या बचता है? पाउडर. व्हाट इज योर रेजिन पार्टिकल्स? ओके, तो वो जाके चिपकता है. सो दैट वो इट मेक अ लेयर ऑफ पाउडर व्हिच इज ऑन द सरफेस. सो वेयर लिक्विड इज इवापोरेटेड बट द पाउडर इज स्टिल देयर. सो दैट इज हाउ द वार्निश इज यूज्ड. ओके, सो इन अमालगम सेम वे. अमालगम में वार्निश अप्लाई किया. वार्निश अप्लाई करने के बाद व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन यू अप्लाई वार्निश टू द वॉल्स? सो After some time, when varnish apply kera, uska jo, as I told you, uska jo apply karne ke baad wo liquid bana, liquid to evaporate ho jata hai. Bachega powder. Powder rahega. Pura wall ko coat hoke. Uske baad amalgam aayega. To gap mein jo hai, powder rehta hai. So gap band ho jata hai. Baad mein kya hota hai? After some time, amalgam jo, wo powder bhi itna strength nahi rehta. Thodi din ke baad powder ja sakta hai. Powder gaya. To powder nikal gaya. To baad mein kya hoga? Corrosion particles wo powder ko replace kar dega. So that is a use. But in a GAC, आप पहले ये apply किया तो powder आएगा ना बीच में. हम GAC कैसे chemically bond होगा? कुछ बीच में आएगा तो bond होगा ही नहीं. Like liquid और powder दोनों आ जाएगा. इसलिए GAC में पहले नहीं करना है. GAC apply होने के बाद, GAC restoration के बाद उसके ऊपर डालते हैं. So same thing, powder will be there on the surface. So वो does not allow the water to come inside because of the powder. बाद में थोड़ी दिन के बाद powder थोड़ा चले जाता है. But तब तक GAC set हो जाता है. That is the use of varnish. There is a favorite Viva question. Many a times which this is asked, whether where varnish is applied before the restoration, where varnish is applied after the restoration. Varnish is applied before the restoration in amalgam. Varnish is applied after the restoration in GAC. Understood, Rishabh? Samajh mein aaya?
Yes. Rishabh? Yes. Yes, sir. Thank you.
Anybody else?
So which one is better, resin modified glass ionomer or compomer?
Actually compomer thoda sa expensive hai. Okay, so because it is like a composite, which is a resin modified GAC is very very good actually. Simple to use, like a powder liquid rehta na, so it is very very simple to use. You can use it with a like a powder liquid only, it is application of base is very very simple, but property wise both are equal. But simple to use is economic and simple to use is resin modified GAC, RM GAC.
All right, thank you, sir.
Thank you, Mitushi. Anybody else? सब समझ में आया जीएसी के बारे में?
सर
राइट ना,
इज देयर अ केमिकल बॉन्डिंग बिटवीन द कंपोजिट एंड द जीआईसी एज वेल, लाइक देयर इज अ केमिकल बॉन्डिंग बिटवीन द जीआईसी एंड द स्ट्रक्चर?
एक्चुअली वो आई वांटेड यू मे बी अंडरस्टैंड, यू मे नॉट अंडरस्टैंड, दैट्स द रीजन आई डिडंट टेल. सी देखो, अभी आपको जीएसी, आपने जीएसी ऐड किया, ओके. जीएसी इज पाउडर लिक्विड, आपने एसिड बेस रिएक्शन होता है नॉर्मल जीएसी, which is like powder liquid, मतलब अपने class 2, type 2 वाला. So उसके ऊपर resin, अपने composite resin किया. But there are chances that composite resin may not get adhered to the GAC. But वही आपने resin modified GAC used as a base, resin modified GAC used as a base, उसमें भी resin है, composite resin में भी resin है. So resin to resin bonding better रहता है. So better to use a resin modified GAC for a sandwich technique than the normal GAC. But you can use a normal GAC, but normal GAC mein bhi aap etch karne ke baad wahi micro mechanical bond ho jata hai normal GAC mein bhi, but resin modified mein better hoga kyunki usme bhi hydroxy methacrylate hai aur resins hai, there is in a composite also resin, so resin to resin polymerization will be better.
Yes, sir.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
Anybody else? Okay. So, good. So you understood about, all of you understood about the modified GAC properly? Class representative, so on behalf of your class. Okay. It's clear? Okay. So we'll end the class now. Okay, tomorrow again I'm going to, so what you want me to teach in composite, because composite is not going to be end in a one class. What exactly you want in composite? Anyone can say what you didn't understand in composite?